City. Jefferson's original instructions to the two men were to attempt to negotiate $10 million to buy either.
So what's our budget?
$10 million. Territory, or at the very least, secure access to the Mississippi River port. Now look at this from the French's perspective. Their plans to establish an empire in the Americas was failing. They feared a war with Britain was imminent, and that their territory would likely be taken by Canada. So they offered the U.S. a deal too good to refuse. They offered not only New Orleans, but the entire Louisiana Territory, and only bumping up the price from $10 million to $15 million. Now, President Jefferson wasn't totally sure about this purchase. He believed that the government should only do what the Constitution said, and there was nothing in the Constitution about buying land from other countries. But the Senate ratified it, and Jefferson allowed it, and thus the United States purchased the Louisiana Territory and doubled the size of the country, gaining 827,000 square miles for a bargain price. This was a turning point in American history for several reasons. It was the start of Manifest Destiny, which was the Americans' belief that it was their right to expand and settle coast to coast across North America. This also led to the Homestead Act, which allowed people to purchase land in the new territories at very low prices. It started at $1 per acre with a minimum of 640 acres, and later was changed to $1.25 per acre with a minimum of 320 acres.
All right, so I'm gonna stop it right there. Thomas Jefferson thought, I have to follow the Constitution. I have to make sure I make good decisions for my country. He sent those two men over there, Monroe and Livingston, okay? He said, I have $10 million, that's it. I don't want to do anything else. The French own this land, but they already know people are coming for it. It might start a war that we don't really want. If we go ahead and give it to you, it'll be yours. It'll expand what you already have. So remember earlier when we talked about expansion, the main goal was to keep going. So look back here at our map. We have these over here, right? What were they called?
The 13 colonies.
Now we've made this purchase. So now we're about this big, guys. Ooh. Wasn't that a good idea?
Yes.
And then on top of that, what is the main trade route in the center? But now people are starting to move. That's why we're moving westward. Westward expansion, yes.
Was Florida a part of the
13 colonies? Florida was not. It was still controlled by Spain. So Spain has this, and Spain has this over here. Okay? Eventually, we ended up getting it. But at this moment, don't even think about Florida. So all we have is this little chunk. Okay? Now, that word manifest destiny. Everyone say manifest destiny.
Manifest destiny.
So we started with the 13 colonies. We moved out a little bit more, but now people that live in America have this idea in their hearts, in their souls, in their brains that said, it is my responsibility to move out west and show people how great this country is. It's my responsibility to move out west and teach the savages. Who do you think the savages were?
The Native Americans.
The Native Americans. Now, is that right to walk around and call somebody a savage? To say that they don't know right from wrong, to say that they don't know what to do and how to live their lives. Melisha, I'm going to come to you and make you act like me.
What?
Is that okay?
No.
So now let's think about the Native American perspective. I've already moved you from your first home. I told you to go that way. But now we're coming this way. And on top of me coming that way, I'm now telling you, you're not acting right, and I need you to be better. Talk to your table partners now. How do you think now the Native Americans? Make sure we're not violent.
This is like different.
Chaos, right? Now, to the Americans, to Thomas Jefferson, this is okay. land over here in this little small section of the states that we have, and we're going to expand. We got this new land. We're going to explore. I'm going to send Lewis and Clark. Let's see what happens in our video.
Lots of Americans began moving to the new land. So many, in fact, that people began to pressure the government to open up Oklahoma Territory, which is previously closed to settlement.
All right, wait. Let me go back. So now people are moving. They want this area. What do we see in this area?
Indians.
The Native Americans. We got different tribes, y'all. So far the rule is no one can go into this territory. So let's look back at our map again. We have this little chunk right here. Now we're expanding to about here. What's included in our purchase?
Oklahoma.
But are we allowed to go there?
No.
Because who did we put in Oklahoma?
Native
Americans. Now, we've already, like I said, we kicked them out of their house. We made the move. We said, this is your land, only your land. We won't touch it. But now, look at our stick figures on our video. What do they want to do?
Open
it up. They want to get in there and see what they have. Yes.
The day it opened, thousands of people lined up along the border waiting. And at noon, the territory was opened and people rushed to claim land. The Louisiana Purchase, no doubt, had a huge effect on America. Just think of how different our world would be today if the purchase never happened. And all that land was never part of the United States, but instead belonged to other people. Events in history would have turned out much differently, and the world could be a very different place today.
Alright. Okay. So, now that we are done, go back to your Padlet. We have three stations set up, okay? We're going to move the numbers a little bit. Station one's going to be at Jayla's table. The computers didn't charge. You do not need your devices except for station three. So go ahead and close up your devices, bring them over here to this table, but you do need your journal and a pencil. And I'm going to describe the station for you. No, you need your journal. All right, so two people at each station for me, please. Station one, two, and three. And just sit at the table, huh? Do you actually have to go? I don't know what that question is.
Like, now that we paid?
It's today. So they're coming to us today. Hey, guys, slide this table back because the computer's in charge. Alright, we're ready? So everyone, open the door for Jakiya for me, please. So pull it back up to Padlet, Jalen. Y'all need your headphones for station number one. You can borrow some of mine off the big computer. Just make sure you put them back. Alright, so y'all at station two. I need somebody at station three. Alright, so I got three people. Two people and three people to Kaya. Oh, you can go back to station three. I mean station two. So we can have an even number. So three people at each station. Just your journal at this one. Alright, everybody good? So before you get started, boys, look up here at the board. Y'all sit down at station three. You need your devices at this one. Sorry. Station three needs devices. So station one and two, you only need journal and station three device. All right, so everybody look up here for me, please. Your stations are described on Padlet. So station one, you're going to do a boggle activity. So my people over there on the computer, station one, scroll down to the blue. I put all the stations in blue. Miss Williams, 321. All lowercase, no spaces. Boggle, you're going to be listening to a 3.5 minute video. Boys, y'all listening?
Yes.
All you're doing, and Jayla, I'm sorry, all you're doing is watching. When the video goes off, there's a timer. Raphael, grab that timer off that table. You're going to, right there behind you. You see the white timer? You're going to have 5 minutes. Is everybody listening? Because you're going to have to go to the station too. You're going to have 5 minutes to write down every single thing that you can remember in your journal on the page that I drew a circle. Everyone right now, open up your journal, find that circle, and I want you to write Station 1 Boggle. Station 1 Boggle. I put a circle in everybody's journal. At the top, write Station 1 Boggle. So when you go to Station 1, that's the circle you're working with. Right now, write Station 1 for me.
Oh my gosh.
Station inside. 1 Boggle.
Inside the circle.
No, just at the top. And when you get back to Station 1, guys, you can read the instructions again on Padlet, but I just want to give you a heads up on what we're doing in stations today. Alright, so Station 1 Boggle, you're listening to the video. After the video is done, y'all are going to set that 5-minute timer and write down everything that you can remember from the video inside of your circle. When the timer goes off, you're then going to talk as a group about all the things that you learned. If someone has something written inside of that circle that you don't have, you then have to write it outside of your circle, okay? Circle of knowledge on the inside, outside of the zone of proximity. Zone of proximity are the things that I need to learn. Does everybody understand that?
Yes.
If you are at station two, you're going to be back there with me. We're going to be learning about primary sources, okay? So I'll bring my laptop back there, and we're going to work on that. Station three, I need y'all to pull up Padlet. Scroll down to station three. You have questions to answer. You have 5 questions. You don't have to write the question, but it's kind of like a scavenger hunt. You're going to use the website to answer the question. Does everybody understand what they're doing in stations today? If you need help, go back to the Padlet for the instructions. Yes, ma'am.
This is never not available.
Okay, I can come and fix it. All right, everybody else know what we're doing? Yes. Station 3, it says use the following websites to answer the questions in your journal. So you have 3 websites and you have 5 questions. You're just writing the answer to the questions inside of your journal. So make sure you write Station 3, okay, on a different page. All right, does everybody understand what we are doing in stations? Stations are in blue on Padlet if you need the instructions. I'm going to go ahead and work with Station 2 in the back, okay? Everybody good?
Yep.
All right, let's get to work. All right, Jayla, here.
Station 4, ball. Do you know where ball goes? Wait, scroll up a little. That's station 2.
Yes, ma'am.
I was off for some reason. At the bottom. There. Mm.
Internet.
Is it not showing up?
Don't start the timer. All you're doing is listening to the video right now.
Okay.
When the video goes off, then you listen to the, you start the timer and write down everything you can remember. All right, girls, hold on. Let me see if I can move this.
Over.
All right, y'all ready? So we are today working on primary sources, okay? So y'all are going to use my computer to get this one done. Turn to a fresh one. It can be this page. Alright, so, do we know what a primary source is? What does that mean? If I have a primary source. Okay, something that I can get to quickly with us. Anything? Alright, so I made y'all some pictures. Well, I showed you a PowerPoint that has some pictures in it. It's not one for us, so, for primary sources.
Look at your weight.